take one more breath here. Sigh it out. Again, as per usual, mindful transition as you come out, inhale, unravel, and exhale. Hug it in. Cross your left over your right, put the right foot down, pick your hips up to the left, off center, inhale. And then exhale, let the legs fall over to the right. And then have your block underneath your left knee. And as the left knee is supported, the body can begin to continue further unwinding. Breathe into the spine, into the lower back. Last few breaths here. Inhale, return to center. Careful transition out of the posture. Hug the knees in. Breathe out. We'll do a couple things before we arrive into our yoga nidra practice. So first, take your hands on your ankles and flex your feet, beaming the heels up to the ceiling, and pull your hands down as you find a brief, happy baby. It's finding something symmetrical here. Bring your feet down to the ground, let your knees windshield wiper to either side. Use your block, or if you do have a bolster, take your bolster, flatten it underneath you, underneath your knees. Lift your bum up and take the bolster right beneath the glutes, not the sacrum, but the glutes. And then extend your legs out in front of you for a sky bridge. So you're extending your legs out long, point your toes, and reach the arms just up overhead. Doesn't have to be all the way, unless if it feels okay for your body. Just start to lengthen out through the front of your hips. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Bend your knees, place your feet down on the mat. Now lift your hips up and take your sacrum on your bolster for a supported bridge, and then bring your knees into your chest and your legs up to the ceiling. And same thing with your arms. Bring your arms up with your legs for Viparita Karani, legs to sky. So just finding a little inversion here to bring everything back into neutral. Feeling and sensing all the energy that's drawing down from the extremities into the core center of all the energy centers down the spine, the chakras. Breathing in. Breathing out. More cleansing breath. Slowly bring the legs and the knees back to the chest. Place one foot down and then the other foot down on the mat. Lift up your hips, turn your bolster on its second height on the edge and crush it with your knees. And then we'll set up for yoga nidra. So nice little guided scan of the body. Personally, I like to take a second bolster over top of the hip region, whether if it's vertical or horizontal, just to place a bit more sense of earthiness and grounding. And sometimes a chip foam block, a covered block, or a pillow, a underneath the skull for a little support in the neck. And then using a blanket to stay just a touch warmer and have some sensation of touch on the body for the nervous system. So take whatever works for you. If you have these props and these equipments at your disposal, it's up to you to decide if they serve you or not. Stretch out your arms, your legs, let your palms face up. Let's take a moment here. That in Yoga Nidra, you're more than welcome to drift into many different states of wakefulness and sleep, anywhere in between as well. Don't feel any pressure in any way, shape, or form. Allow the body, the mind, to simply be in the moment. You've made it. You're here. All that matters is your breath, a little smile on your face, and the sound of your own heartbeat. Cycle of life. Over the course of the next period of time, I'll be guiding you through a body scan. You do not need to move your body physically in any way as I draw your awareness or attention to the parts of the body. Imagining that if you had a magnifying glass or a laser pointer, your inner sight would be concentrating and focusing on the parts of the body that I'm inviting you to bring that awareness to in each moment. Start the practice of Yoga Nidra by bringing our attention to our right hand thumb, index finger, middle finger, ring finger, and pinky finger. All five of the right fingers. The spaces between them. The palm of the right hand and the top of the right hand. The wrist, forearm, elbow, bicep, tricep, armpit, shoulder, waist, hip, thigh, knee, shin, calf, knee, wrist. tightness to the ankle. Achilles tendon. Heel. The sole of the right foot. The right big toe. Second toe. Middle toe. Fourth toe. And baby toe. All five of your right toes. And the spaces between the toes. Feel the right side of your body. Without judgment, without criticism. Just the way it is, the way it is. And then bring awareness to your left hand thumb. Index finger. Middle finger. Ring finger. Pinky finger. All five fingers. And the spaces between them. Bring awareness to the palm of your left hand. The top of your left hand. Wrist. Forearm. Elbow, bicep, and tricep, shoulder, armpit, waist, hip, thigh, knee, shin, calf, ankle, heel, the sole of the left foot, and the top of the left foot. Left big toe, second toe, middle toe, fourth toe, and baby toe. All five of the left toes, and spaces between the toes. Feel the left side of your body. Relax. Soft. Heavy. Grounded. And bring awareness to the soles of your feet. Achilles tendons, calves, knee pits, hamstrings, and inner thighs, your groins, your pelvis, and sacrum, your belly, navel, solar plexus, your lower ribs, and your upper ribs, your heart, throat, collarbones, touch at the base of your throat. An Adam's apple. The back of your neck. Sides of your neck. Your chin. Your jawbone. The tips of your ears. The ear canals and eardrums, both of your ears, your lower lip, your upper lip, both your lips, your upper gums and teeth. And lower gums and teeth. Your tongue. And taste buds. Your throat. And the roof of the mouth. Your entire mouth, relaxed, unclenched, at ease. Your upper lip, your left nostril, and right nostril. The tip of your nose, the bridge of your nose, your left cheekbone, and right cheekbone, left eyebrow, and right eyebrow, left eyelid. Right eyelid, left eyelashes, and right eyelashes, left eyeball, and right eyeball, both of your eyes, calm. Sleepy, rolled back into the skull. Your left temple and your right temple. Your forehead and third eye. Back of your skull. The crown of your head. Just slightly above the head. Setting a sankalpa or an intention, whatever it looks like for you, however it may feel. Saying it to yourself 3 times. Feel your body into the earth. breathing in through the nose now. And exhale. Two more. To bring some gentle movements back through your hands and your feet. And then letting your eye pillow come off of your face to the right or the left. Bending both knees and placing the feet down, removing your props off to the side. Coming onto your left hip into a fetal position. Taking the time to let the body process and nourish to integrate. And then using your right hand to come up to sit on your block for a brief closing seated meditation. Which you can wrap the blanket around yourself if you like. Feeling the sitting bones once again into the earth or your block. Face relax. Noticing all the natural curves of your spine as you tip your pelvis forward through the lower back. Upper back bowing out, lifting out through the sternum, letting your head lean back a bit to find the natural curve of the neck, lifting out through the crown of the head. You notice the body kind of tries to react or tense, or the mind goes off the track. Just try to bring it back to center, bringing in awareness to the tip of the nostrils, breathing in, feeling the cool air on the inhale. And the exhale, warm air coming out. Bring the hands now to meet at heart center. Feeling the lift of the chest into the hands and the shoulders back towards the spine. Here, we'll take the sound of Om once to close practice. Thank you so much for practicing Yin and Nidra. Namaste.